Now it's my pleasure to introduce Professor Salwa Ibrahim. She is the head of nephrology in Kasr Alainy Hospital. And now we have reached to a point where we have almost 100% cure of HCV. We're going to listen about new effect of these drugs, and we'll see the experience of Kasr Alainy Hospital. Fadali Turasan.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Shukran to Maya Hasaballah. This talk is divided into two. The first, I will go through our experience in treating hemodialysis patients. And the second one will be given by Dr. Haseen about cases of new kidney disease after receiving the antiviral therapy. The agenda for this talk will touch briefly on prevalence of hepatitis C in Egypt, prevalence of hepatitis C among hemodialysis patients in Egypt, the impact of hepatitis C virus on patient outcome, how we can treat HCV in hemodialysis patients, our experience and the result, and we'll take a home message. Egypt used to have a very high prevalence of hepatitis C virus in the world, and it was estimated in 2015 that the overall prevalence of antibody for hepatitis C was 10% in the age group 15 to 59 years. Among hemodialysis, the percentage is even higher. It was estimated to vary between 50 to 82% in two series. In our unit in 2010, we surveyed the number of hepatitis C positive patients, and it was around 75%, and we, in that era, all of us used to these very high numbers. Hepatitis C virus has a negative impact on patient morbidity and mortality. Patient can, with hepatitis C can experience progressive liver disease, liver cell failure, non-Hodgkin lymphoma, mixed cryoglobulinemia. They have increased cardiovascular mortality and increased risk of type 2 diabetes and insulin resistance. So it has a very negative impact on patient outcome. How we treated the KDIGO guideline in 2018, they advised to, that we have to assess every patient with CKD for the possibility of getting hepatitis C virus therapy. And in those with GFR less than 30, they advised to use the direct antiviral therapy without ribavirin. Here is the recommendation. As we can see, in those with GFR less than 30, we can start with different regimen according to the genotype. Glazoprevir, retinol-based regimen. Others have used sofo-based regimen despite being out of label in treating hemodialysis patients, and it gave very successful remission rates up to 90% without adverse effect. So it can be used off-label, it is not recommended, but it was used and it can be used. What we have done in Cairo University Kidney Center, this work was started 3 years ago. We screened all hepatitis C positive patients for hepatitis C virus RNA. And we tried to convince all of them to go and get the treatment free in the National Liver National Liver Institute. Actually, 48 of them, 27 males and 21 females, they started 12 weeks therapy of Curevo, which is retinol-based treatment. And it was added to ribavirin therapy, and that was the regimen provided by the National Liver Institute. Two cases received the private therapy, and two cases of them had received the interferon before, during the interferon era. All of them were long-standing hemodialysis patients, and they have been on dialysis for many years. This is the drug combination used, retinol-based therapy, Curevo. It was given 2 tablets every morning. And all patients were advised to take ribavirin with Curevo. Some were given 200 milligrams every day. When they developed the complication, we shifted them to every 200 milligrams every other day. And 9 of them stopped the ribavirin after 1 to 1.5 months because of severe anemia treated with red blood transfusion and erythropoietin. So 9 of them were maintained on Curevo only after 1 to 1.5 months. 36 of them, of the patients who completed the therapy, had sustained the virological response after 12 weeks after the last dose of the drug, and this means we have 90% success rate. 8 cases are still on treatment. 4 cases were resistant to therapy, around 10% of the cases, and 2 of them treated before, so they were not naive. They received interferon before and didn't respond to the direct antiviral therapy. The mortality rate was about 10%. One died of septic shock related to catheter. One of them died because of extensive liver disease and hepatic cell failure and hepatic coma. And 2 died at home for not known reason. The adverse effect, we surveyed the patient after we finished therapy for adverse effect. Apart from anemia, there was no much serious side effect. We have 9 cases who developed severe anemia necessitating blood transfusion and erythropoietin therapy and the stoppage of ribavirin. 5 cases developed recent onset splenomegaly, which might be there is an extent, advance in liver disease. Increased bilirubin level was noted in 2 cases. Mild thrombocytopenia developed in 1 case, and hepatic focal lesion was noted 2 months after we finished the antiviral therapy. After the patient treatment, we moved them from the original hepatitis C virus rooms to the another isolation room, which is PCR negative, HCV positive cases, and we kept them in this room. We didn't mix them with the negative cases, so we kept the treated cases isolated, away from the negative and away from the hepatitis C positive cases. Currently, we have 160 patients in the unit. If we look at their demographics, around 50% are hepatitis C negative. The treated cases represent over around a quarter of cases, 22.5%. The remaining HCV positive cases, 30 cases, we are around 18%. Those on treatment, 5%, and hepatitis B virus cases, 3.7%. And if you go back to 2010, before the start of therapy, we can appreciate the change which happened over the last decade. In 2010, we have nearly 75% of the cases were positive, around 20% were negative, and the same percentage for the hepatitis B. So during the last decade, the demographics of the unit have changed much. Thank you to the antiviral therapy. 1 minute, only 1 minute. So the take-home message. Is that the treatment was successful, was very successful in obtaining remission in hepatitis C virus patients. It was tolerated, apart from anemia. We are hoping to treat all the remaining cases. They are 21 RNA positive, so we are targeting them now. But we need more study. We still more study are needed to know what is the impact of the hepatitis C virus treatment on the patient outcome and the quality of life. And this was our team, Dr. Ahmed Al-Migi, assistant lecturer in internal medicine. He did all his best to convince the patient to go for therapy, and he raised funds a lot for PCR testing every 3 months. And we have appointed 2 infection control nurses. One of them is the head nurse now, and they also did much in this work to get most of the patient treated. And thank you.